So we're going to be working into a little bit of half saddle. It's surprising with half hero or half saddle that a lot of people think that the hip girdle is just the hips itself, but it actually includes the quadricep muscles through the front of the thigh. So from here, Miranda, I want you to shift your weight onto your left glute, and then taking your right knee out to the side, externally rotating and rolling out your calf muscle if you can. And ultimately, we try and keep the knees quite close together throughout this pose. If they splay a little bit, that's okay, but ultimately, we try and keep them close. So from here, you might find you're already getting a lot of opening. If you ever find that your right ankle is causing some problems here, you can always roll up your towel and pop that under your right ankle. Otherwise, if you feel good, slowly walking the hands back. And this pose will start to target both the quadricep, the hip, but we also target the low back. So you might want to tuck your tailbone to take a little bit of that arch out of the back. And if you start to feel quite comfortable halfway down, you can come all the way down onto your back. With every step you take, just checking in, how does the thigh feel? Could it go with more? If that starts to feel quite comfortable again, you might bend your left knee, place the sole of the foot on the floor. Again, checking in, how does the thigh feel? For those of you who are very flexible, very open through the hips, you can always bend that left knee and pull that, or bring that left knee in toward the chest and hug the leg in. You might not need too much, you might need a little bit more. And for those who are hyperflexible, we're not going there today, you might find that hooking your left foot in the strap and stretching that left leg up to the ceiling will give you a little more opening. The beautiful opener for the quad, releases the digestive tract, and amazing for those of you who walk or run a lot.